Welcome to APD iConnect, manually entering service logs. When a provider has to manually enter a service log in APD iConnect, it is done in the consumer record under the provider documentation tab. The provider enters APD iConnect in the service provider role and accesses the consumer record by putting the information into the quick search. Once the consumer record pulls up, to manually enter a service log, you click on the Provider Documentation tab, File, Add Provider Documentation. The Provider Documentation screen will fill in. The start date and the end date are the dates that you are entering for today. If the start date or end date is a prior date, you can change the date to a prior date. However, you cannot change to a future date. The start time and end time is mandatory if the service has a start and end time. In our instance, respite does, so we will enter a start time. And an end time. And in order for the time to populate into provider documentation, you click the Add button. You'll notice at that time the total minutes will display and a delete button displays. However, if it is a change in the start or end time, simply making that adjustment, the total minutes will adjust without you having to delete. In this instance, I'll add 15 minutes. And you'll notice our total minutes went from 60 minutes to 75 minutes. The next step is to pull in the authorization by clicking on the ellipsis next to Auth ID. The authorizations associated with the consumer have displayed, and you'll notice that there is a plus sign by each provider. If you click into the provider, all of the fields won't automatically populate into the provider documentation. However, if you click on the plus sign, locate the exact authorization, in our instance, respite quarter hour, and click into the authorization. Both the activity details and activity services field will auto-populate into the provider documentation. You'll also notice that we also have now rounded minutes because the rule is to round up to the nearest 15 minutes, so APD iConnect corresponds accordingly. The activity details have the division. The provider will be you because you have the active authorization. The worker defaults to the logged in worker who delivered the service, and the status is pending. To change the status to complete, it is a manual entry. Once the provider documentation is finished, it must be in a complete status if it is going to be ready for billing. Activity services, the service respite quarter hour has pulled in. The number of units corresponds to the number of minutes that I entered into the start time and end time, and the total cost has populated. Provider documentation type for our service is a service log, so you click on service log and choose the arrow to push it to the right-hand side. The notes is where the service log entry goes, and it includes all of the entries per the handbook requirements for entering a service log. Once you complete, make sure your status is complete. Remember, a complete status means that it is uneditable. So if for some reason you are not ready to put it in complete, you can leave it in a pending status. File, save and close provider documentation. And now you have manually entered a service log in provider documentation for a consumer. Resources and reference material, such as frequently asked questions, e-learning videos, training manuals, and quick reference guides are located at apdcares.org, the e-learning library. If you get stuck, the APD iConnect support desk has hours Monday through Friday, 8 a.m. to 6 p.m. Their contact number is 1-800-353-5168, and they are there to help you with iConnect support. We also have a dedicated email, iConnect@apdcares.org. You can email here if you have questions or need direction as to which way to go to resolve an issue with iConnect. Thank you for your time. Have a great day.